feels real good losing a fight. Just all that stuff that you've been doing, preparing for that fight goes to your head like right after they said you won. It just feels real good. It's like, yeah, it was worth it. You know what I mean? I did it kind of thing. It's hard to explain the feeling that you get when you win, but it's a real good feeling. Say I got serious in boxing around the year of 2010. I started training in 2009, but we really got serious and said that this is what we were gonna do and start competing and everything. I'd say the year 2010. Right now, what's driving me is my dad. He motivates me. You know, I'm doing this for both of us, really. So. When I win that belt, it's going to be for both of us. So everything he's done, I see the drive that he had and the hard work he put in, and it made me want to do it too. So he's the reason why I keep pushing.
Well, boxing is my passion. I mean, boxing is what I do, is what I know. I mean, to me, boxing is a way of life. Everything, you know, I think they run parallel. You know, I tell my fighters, I tell my son, I tell everyone this, that I feel that life is a fight. You know what I'm saying? The same way you approach a fight is the same way that you approach life. And I'm so in tune with boxing. I truly believe once I see a person or an individual in the squared circle, their behavior tells me somewhat their character in the real world. And 9 times out of 10, or I might be a little bit off, maybe 8 times out of 10, I'm usually right. Just by seeing, you know, you in the ring, I can tell if you're a bully. I can tell if you're really a punk. You know, I could tell a lot of things if you're a coward, because you have different characters fighting for different reasons. You know, so whatever brings that fight out of that individual is personal.
That's up to me. That's up to you.
I tried to keep boxing far away from all of my kids, because boxing is a brutal sport. Obviously, you know, brain damage or death, you know, but on the business part of it too, you meet so many snakes, you know what I'm saying, and have to deal with so many, you know, devils and demons. And it's just an industry that I you know, it's the entertainment field, you know? I mean, what can I say? It's something that it's political, you know? You don't want nobody that you're concerned about really involved. So no, I didn't want him to be a fighter, no.
I think it's very valuable that my dad is training me, not only because he's my dad, but because he's actually been in the sport. He was actually a professional boxer as well, so he knows the ropes, he knows in and outs about this game, and I think that's the best way to go, is to go with somebody that has actually been in this profession, you know what I mean? I don't want to be with anybody that doesn't know what they're talking about and then I succeed or surpass them. So, you know, I think it's very valuable that I'm with my dad.
Go anywhere in the world, any gym in the world, and no matter how good or bad the trainer is, they will tell you, because they've heard it before, that fighting is more mental than physical. But that goes with everything in life, you know what I'm saying? I would personally think, if I had to put a ratio on it, maybe 85-15, 85% mental, because at the end of the day, you know what I'm saying, if you think you're going to win and you prepare yourself, but you've got to think it, you've got to see it up here first. Everything is visual up here, the third eye. So once you see it and you and you're imagining it, your body can go through it a little bit easier. So if I had to put a ratio on it, like everybody else saying 60-40, I would think it's more or less like 85-15 mental. It's very high percentage mental.
I wasn't an amateur that long. Well, I haven't been boxing that long, actually. But yeah, I've had maybe 30, early 40 amateur fights, and then we turned pro. So that was the biggest transition. And then, boom, we're on our way. Well, normal day, I would wake up like 4:35 in the morning, get my road work out the way. Then we hit the gym around 8, 9 a.m. in the morning, and that's when we usually get some strength and conditioning in, a little bit of footwork, road, a little bit of sprints or something. And then later on in the day, around 4:30, between 4:30 and 8 p.m., that's when we would get our sparring in, my bag work, mitts or anything. In the beginning of my camps, we usually start to tone into the diet. So, you know, we cut out all the sweets and everything. I'm still eating my rice and everything, stuff like that. But as it gets closer to the fight, we start cutting a lot of stuff out. So it sucks.
I mean, shit. You ever seen Rocky? Well, go to the part where he's like training for Clubber Lang and shit. Getting ready for Apollo and the Russian. That times four. That's his training. Go rent the movie. You know what I mean? But intense. You know what I'm saying? I mean, his training, I mean, all of my guys, we train hard. We train all day, every day. Team no sleep.
Even when I get that belt, I know that I have to defend the belt, so it doesn't end there. So I just know I have a long way to go. I haven't been boxing since I was a baby or since I was 8 years old. I just started, like I said, since I was 16. So I have a lot of catching up to. I got to complete, just stay on it. You know what I mean? The grind, got to stay on it.
When we decided that he was going to become a boxer, and I told him without planning, nothing is successful, nothing. So we started planning then, and we planned, without going too far into our plans, we planned about how many amateur fights he would have. Right now we're on that course, same course as you know, professional fights. He's well above course. You know, when I turned pro, it took me over 3 years to have the amount of fights that he has right now. And on top of that, I wasn't undefeated. I had a loss. So he's like, he could take a break for a couple of years. I mean, we're above schedule, but right now we're just going to kind of tune up a little bit in the gym, and then we're going to put him on six rounders next, you know? But the plan is a little bit above schedule.
My ultimate goal is to become world champion. And for people to know who I am, I want to make a mark in the sport of boxing. So I want to get that goal.
If you really want to be successful, you've got to be determined, and you've got to just keep going for it, keep going for it, keep going for it. If you really want it, you're going to get it. If you really want it, you're going to get it.